Okay, we have to look at the settings here and see the vertical rails, if they actually work. I've been trying to tune them, and so far I think I may have leveled them, and this slides in easily. We're going to see that it slides also easily. And now, because of this, to me, it seems like they're leveled. There's very little clearance, so I'm going to turn the printer on just to play with the 0.1 millimeter setting to see how much resistance we're getting from when we try to measure this 10 centimeters. And I opened the back and I basically let the rod slide up and down. And this one, it was being held all the time. And like at every little step of the way, it would oppose resistance. And the left one had no problem. You just lift it up and you let it slide, and it just twists and slides all the way down. I had to just look at the back nut that actually holds the rod to see if it's angle that doesn't allow it, and that was that. So what I had to do, I took pliers and I put a folded up bounty tissue and I bent the back rail. So I basically bent this up and down a few times gently to see if it allowed, and I put a little washer on the second screw here, but on this side, to kind of offset this nut to allow the rail to slide gently up and down. If you on its own weight, it would just like screw in, like the one on the left there. This one here, I untighten it a bit so I can work on the offset, because I was getting this fuzz here, as you can still see some remnants of it. And I'm not sure if I over tightened the system after somebody told me to make sure, check the rails to make sure they're tightened. So I'm not sure what this fuzz is still. I still don't know what it is. Basically, that's what I did to try to make these be equalized. So this nut over here was giving me issues. So you can see the little white wire that I put just to use it as a washer to offset a little bit of this screw. Also, I pulled this whole thing. I just put it with the plier and I pushed it upwards. And I also looked here. Look at the motors. The clearance on this one, it's greater than the clearance on this other one. So if we put this wrench, this slides just fine, right? Put this there, slides. Now let's try to the left hand side. That's just for visual cue. This one doesn't slide underneath this motor. Okay, I'm trying and it doesn't. So if the motor is down, I thought that if the motor is a little further down, then that should be it. But then I thought that no, because the screw here, right, maintains where the leveling is. So that means if this maintains that, it doesn't matter where the motor is, because you can have the rod a little further upwards working or not. So I undo this, and so that actually there's drilled holes to this. You can't just adjust this mechanism up or down. It's just drilled holes in the where these screws here, you see these right there, that one, I took this apart, and I took that thing here up here apart. This, I don't understand why these screws are like that, because this one here is very hard to take out instead of put them in like this. I'm not sure if it's a, like some sort of mechanical advantage to have them like that. This one is very hard to work with. This one is easy. So, but if they would have put it on the sides like this, it would have been better. Right, and I don't know why. Also, this, right, this is bent at the factory by, I guess, an automatic machine that bends it. And I'm not sure how much quality control, but I had to bend this a little upwards because this nut here, through which the screw threads, wouldn't allow it to go smoothly. So it is a complicated system to tune for me, and I don't have a lot of experience with it, but it's complicated. And you don't even know what the results will be. Like, if you adjust one thing here, will you see anything in the print and where, and the print quality. Yeah, so it's so difficult to actually know the changes that you're doing. They're the right changes. In addition, it takes a whole lot of time to actually print a result. It's not easy. It took me 24 minutes to print one of these cubes here, right? So I have to wait there for 24 minutes before I get the actual results of my tuning. And with two slicers, obviously, and it's complicated. So this is my take on it, and I think still the jury's out. And if anybody can tell me what this fuzz is, because I've been trying to figure it out, pressure on the wheels themselves or not, or misalignment on the wheels, and the wheels grind and, you know, they fade away. To me now, it's obvious that before you start a major print, like something that's gonna be for at least 10 hours, you should do like a full checkup on the printer. It does its own like bed leveling print, but you do a full checkup. I mean, like, you do a bed leveling, you measure it with the 0.20 millimeter gauge, and you make sure that your nozzle is not too high, not too low for the first layer. Because if it's too high, it won't stick properly. And if it's too low, the nozzle will completely be sealed and it will not extrude material. So it's catch 2020. And because of this gauge here, it's difficult to dial it in to the right setting. And you say, okay, well, I'm going to adjust the bed upwards. But then the gauge will feel that slight difference and it will just home or level the nozzle at the same height you had previously. So dialing it in is a pain. I mean, I've been working on this printer for 4 weeks now, like whenever I get the time to work on it. And it's been taking over my life because this is the only thing I do in my spare time now. I have more knowledge how to quickly, how to obtain like a dial, a level bed fast. But this should be a lot more from the manufacturer, as in the proper settings, rather than myself. And after I got the printer, I looked for whatever they had, and they showed me these videos of what to do, but they didn't explain why and how. I had to figure out a bunch of things on my own and with the help from online. So I did print this sometime ago, like during last week and the beginning of last week, and it printed fine. I mean, it finished. I had to start this a bunch of times because the first layer wouldn't stick, and that was due to the model itself was a little off shape. So what I did, I sunk it into the bed and cura for like 2 millimeters, so I get a first layer. That's great. This had no supports, and this was like, it started like this and it was suspended in the air all the way here, and then it kind of unified with this, and while it was here, this was commencing upwards. So it didn't need supports. I didn't create any supports, and I didn't even want to create supports, and it worked. Now, because of this in the bottom, I'm not sure how well it worked, and I'll let you guys tell me if it's good quality or bad quality. I printed at 40 millimeter speed settings. I had the inlay fill settings. I had a slow speeds like 55. The layer height was 0.3 millimeters. I still get these rings around it, around the print, and like this here, they're obvious. And I would like not to get these rings because the speed was low, everything was low, and the temperature was 220, I think, because some of these I think were due to like extremely high temperature, and the material just slagged down rather than stay straight when the fan would dry it. Maybe that was it, or maybe that wasn't it. I'm not sure. I wanted to print at high temperature, so the subsequent layers just, they melt in and they bind very well with the existing layers. So that's why I chose that. I think I had flow at 95, if I'm not mistaken, or 100%. I'm not sure, because I wanted this to be strong. So that's my rant on the Creality cr10s pro printer. And you wouldn't believe that I have a Creality cr10s 5 printer in a box for like 2 weeks now, and I don't even want to open the box, and I already placed it on eBay and Craigslist to sell it because I'm all 3D printed tuned out.